What do you want?
We reckon you're holding out on us.
Well, what do you mean?
You seem to know an awful lot about a lot of people's business.
My money, for instance?
Yeah, well, I didn't know it was meant to be a secret.
How come Ferguson never touches you?
I lost my remission. What do you call that?
I call that Ferguson's way of keeping a good thing going. Anyone else would have got a punch in the guts.
And we reckon there's only one way that could happen. You've got something on her, haven't you?
Right, you bitch, what is it?
I don't know what you're talking about.
What is it?
Nothing.
Come on, who told you?
Nobody.
Oh, well, if no one told you nothing, how come you know?
Bet she's got something out of Ferguson's file.
Right. That's it. What is it, Fields? We want it.
I haven't got anything out of the file.
Don't lie to me, I'll brain you.
It's only a letter or something. Maybe she's got it on her.
Let's have a gander.
No! Come here, you please! No! Give her a look.
Alone. Sarah. Sarah. Now come on, kids. I bent the rules for you, didn't I? It's time to rise and shine. Will you two quit clowning around?
Oh, my God. Oh, kids.
Come on, let's find out what it is she's been hiding.
To sum up, Mrs. Smith, we're more than happy with the way you've conducted yourself since we saw you 3 months ago. However, prior to this exemplary period, you do have a long history of troublemaking within the prison, with some outbursts of violence, I'm afraid. Well, of course, we don't see this as a bar to granting parole, where we see a person has made genuine efforts at self-rehabilitation. And in your case, I'm sure they're not just a flash in the pan. You should therefore have no trouble in keeping up the effort till the next hearing. In 6 months' time.
Excuse me, sir, did you say 6 months?
Well, there won't be so many questions the next time round. And I look forward to granting your parole then.
Thought you'd be gone by now. Parole board knocked you back, did they? What a shame. Just when you had your heart set on getting out, too. But it's hardly surprising, is it? A double murderess. Couldn't let violent people like you roam the streets. Your type never learn, do you? The only way to treat people like you is to step on them all the time. Got nothing to say, Smith? That's unusual for you. I ought to book you for dumb insolence right now. But there's no hurry, is there? Got at least another 6 months yet.
Oh, thank God. Quick, please, they're upstairs. I don't know, they're just lying there. I think they're
drugs,
dead.
Drugs, is it?
Yeah, it could be. I mean, oh, I don't know, really. Well,
don't worry, lady, it's all right.
Ah, g'day, Tone.
Hi.
Hey.
What do you think of this?
Where did you get that?
Bought it today. Pretty sexy, eh?
I would have thought you could find better things to do with your doll money.
Oh, fair go. A girl's got to have clothes. Could go around naked if you like.
Yeah, well, judging by that, you will be. Maxie, I want to have a little talk to you.
Yeah, what about? Oh, I'll get it.
Hello, Tony Berman.
Hi, Tony, it's Judy. Listen, can you come around straight away?
Why, what's happened?
Well, it's Sarah and Alan. They've, I don't know, I think they're dead, Tony.
Okay, just calm down, Jude. Have you called an ambulance?
Yeah, they're here now.
Okay, just hang on. I'll be over straight away.
What's up?
Trouble at the house. I'll see you later.
Oh, no, I'll come with you.
No, just stay here.
Wonder how B's going down the parole board.
Keep wondering. We'll be the last to know. She's probably down the local boozer right now getting sozzled.
Hope she bloody is. Be better than sitting around here waiting them to fix the bloody dryers.
Bring the screws to tell us if we ask.
No. Wait till lunch. If they only take Barbara's meal out to the back block, well, then we know Bee's gone.
Well, she hasn't.
Oh, Bee, what happened?
Oh, they were very pleased, I think. Such a good little girl. Want me to stick around for another 6 months to show just how good I can be?
Bastards.
Well, how come they let you out of isolation?
Can't keep me there forever, can they?
But I thought they put you there out of the freak's way.
Well, I'm back. So let's just forget about it, okay?
Rotten bastards. After stringing you along all that time.
Ferguson's gonna be worse than ever now.
What happened?
I don't know. Pills, I guess. Sarah seems to be okay and they're working on Alan now. Oh, Tony, if only I had checked on them earlier, none of this would have happened.
Well, come on, you can't be expected to keep tabs on everybody. Besides, if I hadn't been so wrapped up in my own problems, I would have been here to help you.
We've lost him, I'm afraid.
Oh, no, he's dead.
Yeah. She should be all right, apparently. I don't know what they took, but I think he had a lot more than she did. We'll get her straight to hospital.
Alan!
It's gonna be all right, honey. It's gonna be all right.
No way! It wasn't meant to happen like this.
You said she was remanded to the house on a drug charge.
Yeah, possession.
And where did the boyfriend fit in?
Well, she was very keen to see him when she first arrived. Apparently, the father didn't want them to see each other.
So he's been staying here since she arrived?
No, no. This is a home for women only.
But he did stay the night?
Yeah.
My fault. Should have made sure he was clean.
He weren't even here.
Did you suspect him of supplying a girl with dope?
Well, I thought it was possible.
You thought it was possible? And you didn't search him?
Look, well, Sergeant, this is a home. It's not a detention center. Now, if we start acting like screws, we'll never get anyone to stay here. Sarah was desperately unhappy. We wanted to help her.
Miss Bryant, I know you're upset, but Sarah Hamilton was remanded into your care. You were responsible for her. From what I can see, you two could face a manslaughter charge, aiding and abetting a suicide.
Now that's crap and you know it. Do you think if I'd known what was going on upstairs, I would have stood down here and let it happen?
You awake, Bee?
Yeah.
You reckon Ferguson started that rumour about Lizzie?
Who else? She even went the trouble of slipping me a note and signing your name to it.
Well, didn't you recognise my handwriting?
Or when have I ever seen your handwriting? Besides, you said you'd let me know if anything happened. I thought that was it. Well, she's good. She's bloody good. But she's gone too far this time.
Bee, don't do anything stupid.
Why not? That's what got me in here in the first place.
Of course, you've only got 6 months left in here. You've done okay the last three. You can stick it out.
Do you really think the parole board's going to let me out of here in 6 months? First will be another 6 months, then another, then another. Like a carrot dangling in front of my nose to make sure I'm a good little girl. All the time the freak will be on my back. No way. Not for another 6 months. Not even for another 6 days.
What happened?
Alan's dead. Sarah's in hospital.
Oh. Will she be all right?
Oh, maybe. Who knows?
Hey, you look buggered. Sit down, I'll get you a drink.
Oh, no, thanks.
Massage, sir?
Mmm. Nice.
You didn't notice?
What?
What do you think?
You'll catch cold.
Not if you keep me warm.
Maxie, I'm not in the mood.
You could be. You were the other night.
Maxie, that was a mistake. It was just after Melissa had gone.
Yeah, I know. It was on the rebound. So what? You still enjoyed it, didn't you?
Yeah, but
you don't want me to feel like you're using me. Don't worry, Tone. I wouldn't think that of you.
Look, Maxie, last time we got together, there were two kids at the house killing themselves. Now I don't feel like it when I'm going to bed. Good night.
Gaffney, Latham, Lawson, Stokes and Smith to the laundry. Kennedy, Murray and Shepherd, cleaning duty. Right, let's get a move on.
Oh, come on, Bea. Fancy you copying the laundry, eh? I'll tell you what, if you like, I'll let you have a go on the steam press, eh? It's ever so easy, you soon pick it up.
Yeah, help build up your muscles after your holiday in isolation. Yeah.
Bea, like a word with you. In here.
Must be important, or are you going to bash me?
Now, I don't think that's funny.
I'm sorry, but I don't have much sense of humour lately.
I wanted to say I'm sorry about your parole.
Well, as you come, as you go, I'll just have to behave myself a bit longer.
Yes, I hope you will.
Mrs. Morris, you can't blame me for being a bit sour about it.
There's something else.
I thought there might be.
Barbara Field's cell was ransacked by the women a few days ago. Now, they're obviously looking for something.
Maybe.
Joan Ferguson also searched the cell. Now, whatever they were looking for must be pretty important.
Yeah, you could be right.
Now, Bea, you know what's going on. If this is something we can use to get that woman out of here, I want you to help us.
Like last time, you mean, when she wriggled out of it and Steve Faulkner got the boot instead?
We have got to keep on trying.
You could be next, you know, Mrs. Morris. Yeah, okay. If I hear anything on the grapevine, I'll let you know.
I'm telling you, Bea's gonna do something stupid if we don't get rid of the freak first. Look, she'll never get a parole if she cops another murder charge.
What the bleeding hell are we gonna do? Looks like Fields is the only one who's got something on her, but we don't know what.
Well, we could starve her out till she gives it to us. You know, make sure all her meals are covered in salt or something like we did with Kate Peterson.
Yeah.
Oh, great, but we've got to get everyone on kitchen duty on side for that.
Oh, I wouldn't trust some of them if I was you.
Well, what are you lot planning?
How to get rid of the freak, what else?
Well, forget it. That job's taken.
Oh, Bea, please. You'll cop another 5 years. We got a better way.
Yeah, Fields reckons she's got something on her.
I know. Ferguson's diary, she told me.
Oh, all we got to do is grab them off her, give them to...
We can't get them because they are hidden away where no one can get at them, including her.
Where?
I don't know and I don't care. I've got other plans for Ferguson. We don't need any diaries. But we will need Barbara's help. Okay, girl, smoker. And you, Jenny, keep an eye on the door. Look out for screws, will you?
What's plan B? We're all going to get together and bash the hell out of her?
Oh, we'll have to. It's the only way of beating the bitch.
Maybe, maybe not.
Look, you got a chance of getting out of here in 6 months. Don't blow it by copping another murder charge. The freak's just a bully. Show her she can't push you around and she'll lay off. Bullshit. She'll be 10 times worse.
Yes, she's right.
I'll make up my own mind what to do.
Well, if you're not going to finish her off, you can count me out.
I'll bear that in mind.
Well, what's your plan then, Bea?
Ferguson wants those diaries from Barbara, right? I want to lure Ferguson to some quiet, deserted spot. So we use the diaries as bait.
Where are you going to do that?
Well, what is the most deserted spot in the prison?
Well, I suppose it's isolation, but with fields in there, they're bound to be patrolling it every now and then.
So we get Barbara out of there.
How?
As usual, I've got an idea.
Oh, terrific. But have you come up with any idea about how you're going to get away with all this?
It's Mrs. Morris from the Wentworth Detention Centre. I'm phoning about Mrs. Birdsworth. Right, thank you. Mrs. Elizabeth Birdsworth. Oh, that's good. Right. Thank you very much.
How is she?
Much better. Medication's taking effect at last. Doctors don't think she'll be in for much longer.
She'll soon be back in here causing us trouble again.
Should have known you wouldn't be asking out of personal interest.
Of course not. Why should I? She's not a personal friend of mine. The longer she and her lot are out of action, the easier it is for all of us.
I don't know why you don't go and get a job on a sheep station. You'd be just as happy herding animals.
That's what I'm doing now.
Believe it or not, those women are human beings with a lot more human feeling than you'll ever have.
Oh, come off it. Take off your rose-coloured glasses. How long have you been in this job? God, you know, you can't treat whores and thieves and murderers like a bunch of girls at a finishing school.
Sometimes the only difference between an officer and a prisoner is a conviction. I think you're on the wrong side of the bars, Joan.
Maybe. But you'll have your nervous breakdown long before I have mine.
Well, I guess you're glad to be out of that hospital, huh? They always depress me too, you know, all that antiseptic smell and the cleanliness of the place.
Yeah.
Well, why don't you come through, huh? Sit down. I'll make you a cup of coffee or something. Would you like some eggs? If you're hungry, I'll be happy to cook them for you. Sarah, you gotta eat something, honey. You haven't eaten since yesterday.
Judy, is there another room I could have? I don't mind sharing. I just couldn't sleep up there after what happened.
I understand that. I'll organize something, right?
What am I going to do without him?
You're going to go on living your life, huh?
What am I going like?
No, no. Now, look. You just sit down, and I'll make your coffee, and then we'll talk about your room, huh?
Anyone there?
Yeah, just a minute. Put the kettle on, will you? It's you.
I have to see Hamilton. I went to the hospital, but she'd already been released.
And what's it about?
We've got a questioner. There have been certain allegations.
Oh, hell, Sergeant, that kid's been through a really bad time. Can't you wait till she settles down?
I'm afraid not. I've got a warrant.
A warrant? She had nothing to do with Alan's death. He killed himself. He damn near nearly took her with him.
I'm sorry. I've got a warrant here for her arrest on a charge of manslaughter.
You're kidding.
It's all right, Judy. I'll go with him.
Oh, I've got some good news for you all.
Well, that'll make a change.
The freak's just fallen off the roof.
It's Lizzie. She's responding to treatment well and should be out of hospital soon.
Ah, oh, it's the best thing I've heard all year.
Oh, is she allowed visitors, Mrs. Morris?
If you're thinking of volunteering, Chrissie, no, I don't think so. Right, I'll leave you to it.
Hey, Mrs. Morris, how long's Barbara going to be in isolation?
Well, that depends on you, doesn't it? I mean, you can't expect us to bring her back and then let all of you loose on her again.
What do you mean?
You know perfectly well what I mean. She was sent to isolation to protect her from the bullying.
Who says?
Well, the officer who found out about it.
Oh, I see. Right, fair enough.
And what's that supposed to mean?
Nothing. I'm keeping out of it.
Do you know anything about this, Chrissie?
No, I don't know nothing. Honest, Mrs. Morris. Not fair, though, is it?
B, I think it's time...
Look, Mrs. Morris, if you want to believe that we were hassling Barbara, that's okay by me. Right, girls?
Right.
Yeah. You're saying that that isn't the case?
Well, it just seems to me if anyone wanted to get Barbara on her own, they could make up a story like that to have her transferred. After all, I was going to get out of there sooner or later anyway. That leaves Barbara on her pat. That is, if anyone did have that in mind. Who did you say reported that Barbara was being heavied?
I didn't.
Oh, I see. Right. Seems funny no one copped a charge, though.
All right, ladies, you can all get back to work now.
Hey, Bobby, what was all that about?
Just sheer genius at work, that's all. Hey, not bad, Chrissie. Not bad at all.
How's that for being on time, hey? You all right?
I've just been on the phone to the legal service about Sarah. She's been arrested.
Arrested? What the hell for?
Manslaughter, no less. The police have come up with the bright idea that she's responsible for the suicide.
Great. Can we bail her out?
Maybe. Mr. Morton at the legal service said it would all depend on the magistrate, and I'll tell you one thing. If the magistrate says no, I'm going to take him apart.
Yeah, well, more to the point, what'll Sarah do?
I don't know. I mean, I guess she'll have to come back here, but I can't look after every 5 minutes.
Look, I know what you're saying, but I've got my act together now, so you won't be on your own, okay?
Okay. You reckon we should get a psychiatrist to see her?
Well, it can't do any harm, if we can talk her into it. Anyway, the first thing to do is get her bailed out. Well, leave that to me.
Ruth, I thought you must have got flushed away.
Shut up, the freak's coming.
Put that cigarette out, Smith.
I only just lit it.
You heard me. Well done, Smith. Now, that's what I call good behaviour. Keep that up and even I might put in a good word for your parole. That is, if you can keep it up.
Oh, it'll be a lot easier when you're drummed out of the service, Miss Ferguson.
Oh, I'm sorry to disappoint you, Smith, but there's no chance of that.
Really? It's not what Barbara Field says.
What are you talking about?
She reckons you've got something pretty hot on you. She's going to give it to me when she gets out of isolation.
You believe anything. Why doesn't she use it herself if it exists?
Now, come on. You know the answer to that. But when she gets out of here in a couple of weeks, you won't be able to touch her. And she's going to give it to us as a sort of going away present. Round one to us, I'd say, girls.
Just checking on Fields, Mrs. Powell.
She's not here. She's in the governor's office at the moment.
Oh, I didn't know.
And I didn't know you'd been rusted on this floor.
I must have read it wrong.
I don't know. It sounds like one of Smith's pranks. Another smear campaign without any real evidence.
Yes, but it fits in with Ferguson ransacking Fields' cell, and as Bea said, she didn't actually name any of the women who were supposedly attacking Fields.
Hmm. Well, what does Fields have to say about it?
Well, very little, but then again, she could be under pressure. Oh, I don't know. She's outside if you want to have a word with her.
Yes, yes, bring her in.
Fields?
Well, Fields, has Mrs. Morris told you why you've been taken out of isolation?
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
How do you feel about it?
Well, it's okay by me.
Were you being bullied by the other women?
That's why I was sent there.
You're not answering my question. Were you being bullied by the other women?
Yes.
Did any officer make any threats or harass you in any way?
No.
If we put you back with the other women, do you think there will be any trouble?
I don't know. Perhaps.
Do you have anything, some valuable or other, that the women want?
No, nothing at all.
All right, Fields. Wait outside, please. Well, there's definitely something going on. She was very worried.
Yes.
Well, let's find out what it's all about. Put her back with the women. Let the other officers know the situation, and I want her watched very closely.
Oh, blimey, don't put that muck in your mouth. You'll be sick.
It's edible.
Well, I wouldn't be so sure about that. Well, well, right on schedule. All right, you two get lost.
Eh?
Eat somewhere else. Now go on, scram.
That's nice, isn't it? Mm. Perfect.
Sit here, Barbara. Don't worry about that lot. I've told them to lay off you. I also got you out of isolation.
You did? How?
Mum to tell you sometime. But I want a favour in return.
What?
Start eating. You make the screw suspicious. I'm going freak hunting, but I need something to bait the trap. I want you to tell Ferguson you've hidden those diaries in isolation.
Oh, no way. How long do you think I'd last once you discover they're not there?
She'll be in no condition to hassle you. I'm planning a long stay for her in hospital.
No, I'm sorry. There's too much at stake.
You disappoint me, Barbara. You'll make me get nasty, and that's not like me. Now, what do you suppose would happen if I had a word in the ear of a friendly screw and told her about the diaries? I already know you've got something everyone's after. How long do you think it would take for them to find it with all the screws searching? After all, it can't be in the prison, or Margo and Chrissie would have found it already. Therefore, it must be somewhere else, like reception, or the governor's office, or perhaps a storeroom.
All right.
I knew you'd see it my way.
What's this doing here?
Evidently some idiot truck driver brought them in and dumped them there.
Well, didn't you tell him to take them through to the loading bay?
I'm sorry, I wasn't here.
But turpentine, we didn't order this.
I didn't think so. I can't find an order for it.
This is ridiculous. We only ordered 2 cartons for the print show. Oh, God, isn't that typical? The rest of it should have been delivered to Woodridge. Well, look, we can't have it cluttering up reception. Get it removed to the East Wing storeroom for now, and they can take it out of there later.
What is this, Mrs. Powell?
Oh, don't worry, it's not all ours. I'm just dealing with it now.
Good. I have to go out for a while. There may be a call from the Attorney General's department regarding Paddy Lawson. If the writ arrives today, then she can be released this afternoon.
OK, I'll deal with it. Heather, the dispatch manager, please, that number. I want a few words with him.
OK, so Barbara's agreed to lure the freak to isolation.
When?
Sometime after work. We can't guarantee what time she'll turn up, so we need a signal system. You can take care of that, Patty.
And then what? You going to kill her or what?
I'm getting fed up with you. If I kill her, I ruin any chance I've ever got of a parole.
So what are you going to do? Give her a good talking to?
I'm going to put her in hospital for a while, OK? I'll cop another 2 years. But it'll be worth it if it teaches her to keep off our backs.
You bloody piss weak bee. As soon as she comes back, you're as good as dead.
Well, it's my neck.
Well, you can count me out.
What's happening, Bee? You've got a caper going on. Can I be in it?
Oh, great.
Yes, all right, you can give Patty a hand, but right now you can keep knit.
What do you want me to do, Bee?
We need a diversion, something to keep the screws busy.
Oh, it's a shame we're not at Woodridge. I could have done a strip in the yard.
Don't think that'd impress the screws here.
No, I think we'll stick to the old standby, a fire.
That old chestnut. As soon as you yell fire, they're going to know something's
wrong.
Look,
Margo, you didn't want to be involved, so shut your trap.
All I'm saying is it's going to have to be a bloody big fire for them to think it's fair dinkum.
Where am I going to do it?
In here, good a place as any.
What's going to burn in here apart from a couple of old sheets? Why don't you try one of the storerooms?
Shut up, Margo.
I'll get stuffed, the lot of you.
Oh, seconds out of the ring, round two.
Word with you.
What about?
What are you up to? What have you been telling the governor?
Nothing. And why was I taken from the isolation cell? I thought you were going to protect me from the other women.
Smith told me that you promised her the diaries.
Well, I had to tell them something to get them off my back. Look, you've got to help me. I can't keep stalling them forever.
I can't help you. The other officers already think there's something going on. Now, if you want the women to lay off, you give me the diaries and they'll have no reason.
For a price?
What?
You've got to give me a good report at the next classification meeting. I've got to get maximum remissions.
Right. Now, where are they?
How do I know that I can trust you?
You can trust me with one thing. I'll make your life hell if you don't give them to me. Now, where are they?
They're underneath the locker in the isolation cell. Why don't you take a look if you don't believe me?
They'd better be there, or I'll be back.
Right, let's do it. Paddy, you know what you're going to do?
Yeah, come on.
Chrissie, got your matches? Okay, Margo, watch the back stairs. Stop any screws that come that way.
I told you, I'm not getting mixed up in it.
All right, Jacko, you bloody do it. This goes wrong because of you.
You're piss weak, B. There's only one way this thing would have worked, and it's my way.
Later. Where are you going?
I'm just going off to the library, Mrs. Powell. Wasn't much on the telly, so I thought I'd get myself a good book.
Righto. Off you go. Ta.
I must be going punchy or something. I was only going off to the laundry.
So it should be here in half an hour or so. Splendid. Oh, thank you very much. That was the Attorney General's department. They're not proceeding with Paddy Lawson's trial. They're sending the writ around by courier.
Well, that means she's free to go.
As soon as it arrives.
Oh, well, I better go and tell her. She'll have to make arrangements for somewhere to stay tonight.
Well, I'm sure Judy could accommodate her at Driscoll House if she's having any difficulties.
Yes, yes, of course.
I'll come with you if you don't mind. I must admit, I do enjoy being there when the women receive good news.
Anybody home?
Thank you.
Bitch!
I'm glad Paddy's not going to trial. I mean, she's not basically a criminal.
Yes, I must admit, though, I did have my doubts in the beginning.
Mrs. Davidson, quick! There's a fire in the library. There's bleeding flames everywhere.
It's a private party. Who can anyone join in?
Congratulations. You really fooled me this time, Smith. How did you get Fields to set me up?
Shouldn't take much persuading. She's no friend of yours, Ferguson. Then no one is. Now, are you going to turn around and face me, or haven't you got the guts?
Oh, I thought I'd let you hit me from behind. It's more your style, isn't it?
You're bloody fuss weak, Bill. Soon as she comes back, we'll just get us dead.
Just get your children and get out. Well, don't bother about that, Nicholson. Just get your baby out.
Come back! I think Colleen's trying to arrange it now.
All the right gates aren't open. It could be women still trapped in there.
But the fire brigade will be here soon. They'll get them out.
It could be too late. Someone has to open those gates.
Erica, we can't afford to risk another life.
It's my responsibility, and I wouldn't ask anyone else to risk it.
Erica, come back!
Where are you going, Mrs. Morris?
Governor's gone to unlock the gates!
You can't go in. The smoke's getting thicker. It won't last 10 minutes.
Be a fool. It's a fire. Spring. Give me the keys and we can both get out.
Get out.
What am I going to get out for? Throw the keys over here.
No family and no future.
Come on. Smith, there is some time.
Sorry, Joan. There's no way you'd help me get out of here. It's a real good job this time. I'm gonna die right here. You're gonna go in with me.
Give me roses, I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare.
Right.